This is a demonstration to hang an overhead transformer on a wooden pole with rigging equipment. I pre-inspected all my rigging equipment. Everything is good. I have my bolts, I have my short bucket, hand line, all the ropes I'm gonna need and rope locks, okay? So everything's good there. Check the weight on the transformer. I'm gonna go through all my safety procedures, self-checks. First thing I would do is self-check for my personal protective equipment, which is hard hat, safety glasses, chin strap down, leather gloves, proper clothing, and proper footwear. Next, I would do my tool inspection, my personal tools, my climbing belt. So I'm gonna take a look at my climbing belt first. Got it laid out here. I will take a look at my gut strap, look at the tongue, make sure no stitching, look at the D-rings, everything's good there. This is a new belt, it's in good shape. Look at the D-rings, everything's good there. The buckle, all the rivets, good shape, no stitching missing. While I'm here, I'm gonna check my secondary safety, check that snap hook opens and closes properly. Check that it will not open accidentally. There's a safety catch on that, prevents it from opening accidentally. Check the carabiner. Make sure the carabiner opens and closes properly. Check the rope grab. Make sure the rope grab's in good condition. And it's fine, it's working fine. Check the general condition of the rope, all good. Go to my climbing belt, starting with the tongue. Come across the holes, no stitching, everything is good. While I'm here, check the D-ring. Check my roto snap. Everything's good there, it's opening and closing properly. Check the carabiners. Carabiners are working properly. Everything's good there. Check the general condition of the inner strap of the Super Buck. Somewhere, general wear, but everything is good. All the rivets, everything is good there. Check the outer strap, all good. No rivets, anything loose. Check the web grab, it's in good shape. Make sure it operates properly. Everything's good there. Check that I have all my tools. Hammer, crescent wrench, all my hand tools, pliers, screwdriver, knife, everything's there. All my hand tools are there, so I'm gonna have all the tools that I'm gonna need to complete this task. Take a look at my climber, same process. Top to bottom, take a look at the top strap. Buckle's good, that strap's in good shape. Everything's good on that strap. Take a look at the pad. Some general wear, but it's really in good shape. No rivets, no stitches torn or missing. Everything's good. Check the shank, make sure the shank is not loose or any damage. Take a look at the bottom strap, buckle, the rivets. General condition of that strap is excellent. Take a look where it's attached to the foot plate. It's good there. Check the climber gaff to make sure it's properly sharpened and sharp, and it is. Repeat the process with the second climber. Start with the top strap. All good with the top strap. The top pad, no stitching, no rivets torn or missing. Everything's good. Check the climber shank. Everything's tight. Check the bottom strap. Check the buckle. Condition of the strap is good. Check where it's attached to the sole plate. All good there. Check the climber gaff. It's properly sharpened and sharp, and it is. It's in good shape. Okay, I'm gonna do a pole inspection. Start with a pole inspection. So what I'm gonna do with the pole inspection is top to bottom. Really should be done before you touch the pole. You should not touch the pole until you've done this inspection. So I'm gonna look up. There's conductors up there. Going right, conductor going to a pole to the left. So all that has to be inspected. For the pole that I'm gonna climb, I'm gonna start at the bottom, start at the top, work top to bottom, general condition of the pole. I'm looking for any kind of large cracks, damage, woodpecker holes, things like that. This pole is in good shape. It's fairly new. I established my climbing area, and I'm gonna probably climb right here. Probably gonna work right on this quarter. It's in good shape. Then I would inspect the conductor that's going to the left, make sure that conductor's not damaged, make sure it's secure. Nothing can give me any kind of heartburn or headaches from that pole to the left. Look to the right, inspect all the conductors, taking a look at each conductor, make sure there's no damage to the conductor. Look at that pole to the right, top to bottom. There's no loose hardware, nothing up there that can come loose, fall, or break. It's all good. Then I need to do a sound test on this pole before I climb it, and a check for butt rot or ground line rot. So first thing to do would be sound test it. And that pole's nice and solid. You can tell by the rebound of the hammer and the sound. If it was rotten, it would be a dull drum-like sound. And then the next check would be to dig down minimum on 2/4 and check for rot. So dig down about 6 inches. Drive your screwdriver in at about a 45 degree angle. That's going in pretty solid. Come to another quarter, same process. Dig down approximately 6 inches. Drive your screwdriver in. If it goes in nice and solid, it's an indication the pole is in good shape. If in doubt and you feel that it could be rotten, do not climb it. Get help, secure it. The pole would probably have to be replaced. Okay, the next step I'm gonna do is talk out a job plan. So, safety is important to us here at Blue Ridge Community College, so I'm gonna start with safety. I've done all my personal protective equipment checks, got Jim Bailey, Dwayne Robinson is gonna assist, and I've looked at those and they did the same. They have checked, they have all their proper personal protective equipment on. We have a work zone established. It's for qualified and unqualified workers. We have a zone established that anybody comes into our work area that's unqualified, They can't come in. We watch for that and protect our public personnel and anybody that's not qualified. Qualified personnel can be inside of our work area, and that's what it's set up for. So we're going to establish a 15-foot circle around the bottom of this pole, what we like to call is a safety zone. Any of our qualified people that come in must echo, and they will yell up or talk up, I'm coming into the impact zone, I'm coming into the safety zone. It's important because if things are dropped in this area and you're in that zone, you could be struck by a falling object. So we're gonna establish a 15-foot circle, please. Jim, Dwayne, let me know when you're coming in. I'll echo back to you.
Absolutely.
Okay? So, with that being said, I'm gonna go ahead and talk out what I'm gonna do. Essentially, I'm gonna tool up. All my inspections have been completed. I'm gonna tool up, climb up, install my rigging, call for that transformer, set the transformer on the bolts. Once I got it secure, I'll take it off and we'll bring it back down to the ground with Dwayne and Jim's help.